So hello friends, good morning. Today I will discuss about the crossing over, its theory, its component, the important point. So friends, I will divide this whole crossing over video into two or three parts. So I, Vikas Mangal, scientist, genetics and plant breeding, creature of Barakpur. Now coming to the, actually I will, this is the content I will cover in this whole videos of crossing over the molecular basis of crossing over, theories of crossing over, cytological basis of crossing over, factor affecting crossing over, and change metaformation and significance of crossing over. So in this video I will discuss only about this crossing over component. So what is crossing over? And we all know that this crossing over term given by Morgan and Cattell in 1912. So this video is exclusively for the UG student or JRF student. So some things are very important and basic fundamental things I will discuss. So what is crossing over? As the this name indicates, the crossing, and over, crossing means the crossing, over means to exchange, overlap. So the exchange of homologous segment between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome. It means in these are the homologous chromosome, and in a homologous chromosome these two things, this and this, they are sister chromatid. Okay, these are sister chromatid, but at combinedly this and this, they are called non-sister chromatid. So crossing over occur between the non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome. Okay, so we all know that ki before crossing many processes are occur in the prophase. So I will discuss like ki crossing over occur between non-sister chromatid of synapse homologous chromosome. Synapse means ki before crossing over some type of pairing occurs. So this pairing is called synapsis. Okay, I will discuss what is tetrad. Okay, in one chromosome two sister chromatids are there, so this is called dyad. So because in a chromosome two chromatids are there, so two chromatid plus 2, so 4 chromatid, so this is called tetrad. It means the crossing over occur in the tetrad stage, crossing over occur after synapsis, crossing over occur in non-sister chromatid, crossing over occur between homologous chromosome, many things are there. So after crossing over the product, so this is called recombinant. The recombinant is the product of crossing over, so this is here in between non-sister chromatid only one crossing over is occur. There is no another place where crossing over occurs. That's why this is single crossing over. So this is just crossing over. They are over. That's why this term comes. This over to each other. So after that, these are the parental combination. One is maternal and parental, but these are different because here some different parts are there in a single chromosome. So these are called recombinant. Okay. Now the crossing over. So I have told it takes place during pachyton stage. This question comes in every exam, very basic questions, takes place in pachyton, which comes in prophase first of meiosis. Crossing over doesn't occur in mitosis, crossing over occur in meiosis, prophase first, and in prophase first the pachyton stage, and it occurs in four strand stage, means tetrad stage. So one chromatid from each homologous chromosome involving crossing over. This is most important. This chromatid is not involving crossing over, only this chromatid. Here this chromatid, it means in one homologous chromosome one chromatid is involving crossing over, another chromatid is not involved, because this concept is important. I will discuss. So one chromatid from each homology is involving crossing over. Okay, and each segment of one chromatid become attached in place of the homologous segment of the non-sister chromatid. Here you can see this portion of this chromosome attached to this portion. Here you can see this. So it means the one portion of any chromatid attached to the same portion of homologous chromosome. So that's why they are called recombinant. So a segment of one chromatid become attached in place of the homologous segment of the non-sister chromatid. So crossing over occur in the meiosis stage. Okay, so before crossing over The interphase comes. We all know that these are the some basic things. Interphase come. In interphase, you know, chromosome replication or DNA replication occur. Okay, and mainly chromosome in uncondensed state means you cannot differentiate chromosome. You cannot. They are not properly visualized. They are visualized after condensation process. So in interphase, that's why the heterochromatin, euchromatin part we can see only in interphase stage. So before prophase, first this interphase comes where many processes are occur. Okay, so here chromosomes are called actually the chromatin material. So this chromatin convert chromosome into the prophase first after condensation process. So chromosome replicate forming sister chromatid. Okay, now in prophase first meiosis, prophase first comes here. We divide prophase in early prophase first and late prophase first. So in early prophase first, first chromosome condense, they will thick. That's why you can differentiate chromosome and nuclear envelope breaks up. Definitely this nuclear envelope break up. Spindle apparatus form. These are the spindle apparatus, because in anaphase you will separate these chromosome to the different pole. That's why we need spindle apparatus. And synapses of homologous. Synapses means the homologous chromosome, they will come near to each other for pairing. This pairing, so sometimes the one theory is there ki in between this homologous chromosome, synaptonemal complex is there, which is responsible for this pairing, but it is not totally proved. Okay, so in late phase, so ultimately by combinedly 2 plus 2 they are cut tetrad stage, because for crossing over this tetrad stage is necessary. And late prophase, so crossing over occur in Pacatin stage of non-sister chromatid. Okay, so often multiple crossover between the same chromatid. I discuss earlier ki one crossing over event, but not one, many crossing overs are occur. So here you can see 1, 2, 3 crossing over occur. It means multiple crossing over occur in between two chromatid of two different homologous chromosome. It means after meiosis, two types of product will be formed. Okay, recombinant and original chromatin. Here you can see this combination. This chromatin is not participating in crossing over. This chromatin is not participating in crossing over. It means these chromatin will form the parental gamete, same zygote or gamete. You can see anything. Because they are not participating in the crossing over, but those chromatid which are participating in the crossing over, they are forming different product. It means they are called non-parental product or recombinant product. It means after crossing over, now you can see after crossing over, two types of product are formed. First one is the recombinant chromatid. They are called crossover chromatid because they are participating in the crossing over. And original chromatid means same like parent. And they are also called non-crossover chromatid because they are not participating in the crossing over. So here you can see ki meiosis but without crossing over. Suppose crossing over is not there, it means crossing over is not there, that you will not get recombinant product. So you will get only this parental product. Okay, if meiosis occur with crossing over, it means you will get both recombinant and original. So these are parental and these are parental. So these same, these and this is same. So these are called parental, and now they are different. Here you can see different parts are there. So these are called the recombinant. So the recombinant are the product of crossing over. So non-crossover, so you here you can see the non-crossover means the original chromatid. Original chromatid means the parental chromatid. Okay, so here you can see the non-crossover is also called the parental phenotype, definitely. Okay, so ultimately what is the role of crossing over? You can see ki it leads to the separation of the linked gene. Obviously, what? Obviously, because they are creating different product which is not present in the parental combination. They are creating some different product. It means they are separating the linked gene. Okay, now coming to the crossing over frequency. So what is crossing over frequency? The total number of actually recombinant is the product of crossing over. It means they will participate in crossing over frequency. So total number of recombinant upon total. Okay, so this is called crossing over frequency. Total progeny, it means both recombinant and parental. So number of recombinant upon total progeny into 100. So this is called the crossing over frequency. Now you know one thing, out of these four chromatid, two chromatids are only two chromatids are participating in in crossing over. Two are not participating in crossing over. It means the crossing over frequency, if two chromatids are participating whole, it means crossing over frequency can be maximum 50%, because only two chromatids are participating out of four chromatids. So crossing over frequency can be maximum 50%. It means in all the time the crossing over frequency definitely will be less than 50%, because both two chromatids can't be participate 100%ly. Okay, so these points are important. So it means the crossing over, the value of crossover or recombinant may vary from 0 to 50%. It means crossing over can be 0 or crossing over can be only 50%. Crossing over cannot be occur more than 50%, because out of 4 only 2 chromatids are participating. Now many confusions were there in starting ki crossing over occur in 4 strand stage or 2 strand stage. So now we all know that ki crossing over occur at 4 strand stage or tetrad stage. So here you suppose crossing over occur at 2 strand stage, then what product will form? These are the 2 strand and crossing over occur. Okay, the after first meiotic division and second meiotic division, you will get all recombinant product. Okay, suppose crossing over occur at 4 strand stage, here 2 strand are crossing over occur in 2 strand, 2 strand are participating, here 4 strand are participating. Okay, 4 strand are participating, but out of 4, 2 strands are actually in crossing over. So after this first or second meiotic division, you will get the parental combination and recombinant combination. It means these are the correct. It means crossing over occur at 4 strand stage. This is accurate and correctly. Okay, in the next crossing over video, we will discuss the molecular mechanism of crossing over. So please note down all the important points. So thank you all of you for watching our video.